All right, the M4 MacBook Air is here. But how does it really stack up against the latest chips from Intel and AMD? We're putting it head-to-head with the Core Ultra 5 and the Ryzen AI 7. Forget the hype for a second. Let's dive into how these machines actually perform. You might genuinely be surprised by what we found. Okay, let's kick things off with raw processing power, the CPU benchmarks. We ran Geekbench 6, and honestly, the results for the M4 are kind of eye-opening. This chip isn't just beating the Intel Core Ultra 5 125H and the AMD Ryzen AI 7 we tested. It's actually posting better CPU scores than even the older M1 Pro chip. Now, that's pretty wild for a laptop positioned as the entry-level Air. Whether you look at single-core or multi-core performance, the M4 is seriously leading the pack here. What this means for you in daily use is just buttery smooth performance across most common tasks. But here's something that's always been a Mac advantage, and it still holds true: performance consistency. You unplug those Intel and AMD laptops, and you're likely going to notice a drop in speed as they try to conserve power. The M4 MacBook Air, it barely even notices. Maybe you lose a tiny percentage, but you're essentially getting full throttle performance whether you're plugged into the wall or working from a coffee shop. That consistency is a massive plus for anyone who needs reliable power on the move. Now, let's talk graphics. Again, using Geekbench to get a baseline, the M4's integrated GPU manages to outperform the graphics built into both the Intel and AMD chips in this comparison. It's worth noting, it doesn't quite reach the graphics power of the older M1 Pro chip. Remember, that was specifically a pro-tier processor with more graphics muscle. But compared directly against the specific Core Ultra 5 and Ryzen AI 7 configurations, the M4 holds its own and then some, which is impressive for the Air lineup. Benchmarks are useful, sure, but what happens when you throw a real-world task at these machines? We fired up DaVinci Resolve and gave them all the same video project. To export, the M4 MacBook Air crunched through it in just under 8 minutes. Pretty quick. The Intel machine? It took nearly 14 minutes. The AMD system was a bit quicker than Intel, clocking in around 13 minutes. Guys, that's not a small difference. That's a huge gap. In this specific video editing scenario, the M4 isn't just slightly faster, it's significantly faster. We used the free version of Resolve, which typically leans heavily on a single GPU, so this test really highlights the efficiency and power of Apple silicon for these kinds of tasks. And it's not just about benchmark numbers or single export tests. I was actually chatting with a content creator friend the other day. They started out editing their TikTok videos on an M1 MacBook Air, and it worked fine for them. But recently, they upgraded to the M4 Air. They told me the difference was immediately noticeable. Smoother timeline scrubbing, faster render times, just a generally snappier editing experience overall. So while the MacBook Pro line with M Pro or M Max chips are the undisputed champs for heavy video work, don't automatically dismiss the Air. For lighter editing, especially short form video for social media, the M4 Air is proving surprisingly capable. I was genuinely impressed to hear that. Okay, let's touch on gaming. Look, we have to be realistic here. While you can play some games on a Mac and the M4 has decent graphics power for what it is, the Windows platform is still king for gaming. Overall, the game library is just vastly larger and you get better support for the really demanding AAA titles. We initially thought about testing Counter-Strike 2, a hugely popular game. Then we remembered, right, there's no native Mac version. So bottom line, if gaming is a major priority for you, the Windows laptops running Intel or AMD generally offer a better experience simply because more games are available and optimized for that ecosystem. Now for something a bit more cutting edge. We tested running local large language models using LM Studio. This is where things got quite interesting. The M4 MacBook Air was noticeably faster at processing and generating text, higher tokens per second compared to the Intel and AMD laptops. The key reason? The M4 can leverage its built-in neural engine and unified memory architecture to accelerate its AI tasks using the GPU effectively. On the Windows machines in this comparison, which lack powerful dedicated graphics cards, we were mostly limited to running the AI models on the CPU. And for this kind of workload, the CPU is just much, much slower. So if you're experimenting with local AI tools, the M4 Air has a clear advantage here due to its hardware acceleration capabilities. Battery life, always a critical factor for portable machines. We ran our standard office productivity test script on all three laptops. The M4 MacBook Air consistently lasted about 1 hour longer than both the Intel-powered ZenBook and the AMD-powered ZenBook. Now, let me be clear, getting around 8 hours on the ZenBooks in our test is still very solid performance. They aren't bad at all. But the M4 just manages to sip power even more efficiently, stretching that battery life further. It really highlights the efficiency Apple has achieved with their silicon. So let's wrap this all up. Based on these tests, looking purely at performance, especially for creative tasks like video editing or even emerging workloads like local AI, the M4 MacBook Air is putting up a seriously strong fight. It's often significantly faster than the Core Ultra 5 and Ryzen AI 7 configurations we compared it against. Plus, it delivers that performance consistently, whether plugged in or not, and offers superior battery life. And let's not forget, Apple finally starting the base Air with 16 GB of RAM is a very welcome change, making the value proposition much stronger. Where do the Windows laptops like these ZenBooks still hold an edge? Well, the most obvious answer is Windows itself. If your workflow absolutely relies on specific Windows-only software, perhaps complex Excel models with macros not available on the Mac version, certain engineering applications, or that wider gaming library, then a Windows machine is clearly the right choice. But if you're flexible with your operating system, and you're looking for a thin, light, powerful, and incredibly efficient laptop for everyday tasks, content creation, schoolwork, and even some surprisingly demanding workloads, the M4 MacBook Air is making an incredibly compelling argument right now. It's a fantastic machine that punches well above its weight.
If you enjoy this video, please like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell to the latest update from my channel. Thank you for watching till the end, and see you in the next video.